Good afternoon. The first item of business this afternoon is Time for Reflection. And our Time for Reflection leader today is Dr. Mary Jockey, PhD, Research Fellow at Stirling University and Social Worker.
Thank you. Thank you, Presiding Officer, members of Scottish Parliament, for this opportunity to lead the Parliament in Time for Reflection. Where do I belong? Where is home? When I visit my home country, I'm often told I no longer belong because my thinking and my way of doing things have changed, especially expecting people to queue or my impeccable timekeeping. And if I complain, when someone is an hour late, they proclaim, I am now here. That is all that matters. When I am in the UK, I am constantly asked, where are you from? A question that reminds me I am an outsider, having come from elsewhere. I grappled with my sense of belonging until I decided I belonged here, there, and everywhere. And most importantly, I belong to myself. This meant I do not need to belong to a specific geographical location. Some Scottish friends have told me, you belong here. We want you here. You are even more Scottish than some of us with the different courses you do. While beautiful, this was not convincing. However, recently, an occasion made me to review and reflect on my sense of belonging. August 22nd, we celebrated my very belated 40th birthday, 2.5 years later due to COVID. My neighbors hosted my guests who had traveled from different parts of the world. One person whom I had never met hosted my Belgian friend after I was told to post a request on our street WhatsApp group. Another neighbor harvested tons of apples from her allotment for the party, while another collected wood donation for other neighbors for the bonfire at the beach after party, which she manned. Other neighbors dealt with all the recycling needed after the party. Another offered to be the DJ of the after party, and many kept asking what they could do to help during this time. I had never experienced such neighborliness. Their gesture, generosity, and kindness touched me deeply. This experience made me realize whether I felt I belong or not belong in Scotland or Kenya, I definitely belong in my neighborhood. This sense of belonging helps in building resilience, reduces loneliness and isolation for those coming from elsewhere and making Scotland their home, and also for those born in Scotland. I urge you all to promote and support activities that help build community capacity and cohesion that enhances well-being, sense of belonging, and supportive neighborhoods in Scotland to improve people's quality of life and connectivity. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Jockey.